The gravesite of Old Chief Joseph, the father of the famous Chief Joseph of the Nez Perce Indians, overlooks Wallowa Lake, the gem of the fertile countryside now known as the Wallowa Valley in northeastern Oregon. And today is even more famous with fishermen as the producer of the new world record kokanee at nearly 10 pounds. A great way to see the lake and the magnificent Eagle Cap Mountains is to ride the tram, which gives you an eagle-eye view of the Eagle Cap Wilderness Area and the incredibly fertile Wallowa Lake. The Eagle Cap Wilderness Area is by far the largest wilderness area in Oregon, with peaks reaching nearly 10,000 feet, from which the glaciers came that eventually formed the nearly 900-foot-deep Wallowa Lake. On top, you can enjoy the view and even have lunch before the long, slow descent over the pathway of ancient glaciers.
Actually, there's been 9 glaciers that have gone through here that scoured out this lake, beginning about 300,000 years ago, and the last glacier was 17,000 years ago. The glacier was called the Wallowa Glacier, and it's formed the East Moraine and the West Moraine and the Terminal Moraine, and that's what actually formed the lake. And the moraines are about 1,200 feet high, with the base of them deep in the lake. And there's actually 2 other moraines that are in the bottom of the lake. Not many people know about that.
But one thing we do know for sure is that Wallowa Lake is a world-class trophy kokanee producer. Just ask Ron Campbell, the new world record kokanee holder. And today, we're on the water with Ron Campbell. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. We're on Wallowa Lake with record kokanee holder Ron Campbell and Gary Morales of Shasta Tackle. Earlier in the spring, Ron used Shasta Tackle to establish the new world record. But now, in midsummer, we'll start off with something a little smaller.
And it's not much of one. There we go. It's not quite what we're after out here in this lake. He kind of swiped at it. This looks more like what these kokanee would eat. This someday will be a 10-pounder. I'll let him go. Catch him about 3 years from now.
These little maggots, some people don't like them, but as long as the kokanee like them, that's what's important. Game biologists claim that the mysis shrimp come up early and the fish follow them up toward the surface. And that's what makes the fishing generally good early, shallow. So we'll see if that holds true today. So I
got some. Got him?
Yeah, I think so. He's a little burger, I think. Little guy.
A trout?
Little trout.
Yeah, I've got a few of them in here too.
A lot of trout, especially hug the edges here. The sling blades are the flesh in the morning on the surface, shallow. It's possibly what they're chasing, thinking it is a fish. And at least it's bringing them to the bait. And we'll try it again here and see if that theory proves out here.
You know, Ron, last time I was here, we caught a 7-pound rainbow out of here. So when we hit that trout, this one, there's one right there, bud. And I decided I'm gonna go back with a crippler, which is my favorite trout lure. I'm gonna run that on the surface. Maybe we'll hit one of those big trout.
This episode of Angler West TV is brought to you in part by Van Warmer Resorts, Procure Bait Sense, P-Line, and Max High Definition Sunglasses. Welcome back to Wallowa Lake. I'm Justin Wolf. World record Kokanee holder Ron Campbell and Gary Morales are fishing the same area in the same lures that Ron used to establish the new world record earlier in the spring. But now it's midsummer, when the big fish are less likely to be had.
About 500 yards, and then we'll don't pick up any quality fish. We'll go to plan B, and that is to move out into the deeper water and see if we can pick up any good Kokanee out there. Sometimes as the sun gets on the water here, they may come up out of the deep, and we can get them out there. So try 40, probably trolling in about 40 feet.
We've got fish I'm seeing here right at 40 feet, and we've stayed approximately 5 feet above them, so we're right around 35 to 30 feet above them. So at the secondary line, they should be looking up at the bait.
Oh, they're taking some line. Yeah. Well, we've been catching a lot of trout this morning. This one right here, go ahead. This one's a little bigger fish. You know what's amazing about the trout in here? Is that they're hitting these hoochies. You know, this is your standard Kokanee setup. And I mean, that's a nice trout. I don't care what lake you go to. Planner been in here a while, looks like. But yeah, good little fight. But not quite what we're looking for.
Well, on June 13th of this year, I caught a 9.67 pound Kokanee on this outfit. Shasta tackle sling blade. Shasta tackle Tequila Sunrise Hoochie. And as you can see, I prefer live maggots that go on them. You want to be well equipped with line and good knots if you're going to tangle with one of these big Kokanee up here at Wallowa Lake. This is the setup I like to use. I prefer a little stiffer pole than a lot of Kokanee rods. This one here is a Lamaglass Cascade Pro XT. I've got a 4500C Ambassador reel on it. This reel has a little history in that several years ago I caught the state record largemouth bass on the same reel. And so it's got some history, still cooking along as you lube it up every year. The line I'm using is 10 pound P-line. I prefer the high contrast and so I can see it. And then obviously the sling blade from Shasta and the Tequila Sunrise Hoochie from Shasta Tackle.
Well, I just barely got it down there, and here's a fish. It's definitely a Kokanee. Got the net handy? It's not a big fish, but it's a Kokanee.
This lake, in my experience, has been, it turns over at a certain point, and usually that occurs around, you know, July 1st, 4th, right in there. And when that occurs, well, the thermocline water temperature gets so hot that the fish start going deep. And I think that's what we're experiencing today, is that we're finding the fish down quite a bit deeper. I've been trolling here at 40 feet to 60 feet, and we're still marking quite a few fish at that depth. Wallowa Lake is kind of a natural lake formed by a glacier. You can see the glacier moraines around both sides of it. The lake is actually, I've dove in this lake, the lake is actually much like a teacup. Slope sides down to a flat bottom in the middle. We're pretty close to that deepest portion right now, 283 feet, and it's 289 approximately the deepest portion. Very clear lake, very clear waters, very pure.
You know, Ron, is this this year's fish? I mean, this is a natural reproducing lake, right?
It is. The fish spawn up the creek in the park, and it's kind of neat to go up there in about a month and start seeing all the fish under the bridges there. But this is probably a year-old fish. That's a trout, I think.
No, I think it's a trout.
Well,
there we go. That's a fair fish, huh? Now we got both hooks too.
Yeah. Good fish.
Yeah. That's a good Kokanee anywhere.
And catching this big fish was quite an experience. Something I didn't ask for, but here it is. I've had calls from internationally, actually. I just had a call from the United Kingdom, a gentleman wanting to come over here and go fishing. I think he was kind of asking me if I would take him fishing. I pretty well indicated that probably next spring before he should entertain that and get the bang for his buck to fly clear over here. But it's just generated so much excitement. I've been approached by a lot of different people to be on talk shows. I've done 4 talk shows in California. It's just really created a lot of excitement, and I think that's fun. And the record, if it certifies here in about a month, will be wonderful. It'll be a once-in-a-lifetime for me. Records are made to be broken. So I think that there's a big brother in this lake here. And spring will tell us whether somebody can find him or not. It's going to be interesting to see what Wallowa Lake does this next year. These fish appeared really quickly. The big fish appeared really quickly, and so it'll be interesting to see if they are here when spring comes. So June or so will tell the tale next year as to whether the fish have gotten bigger or whether they're actually in a decline. Right now, it's very apparent that they're turning red, getting ready to pre-spawn. We've had one report of fish being seen fitting up the river, the mouth, so it sounds like they're starting to work into their fall routine. But next year will tell the tale. Do the big fish get bigger, or do they go into a decline?
Wallowa Lake is truly an outstanding fishery, not only for kokanee, but also for rainbow trout and mackinaw. And for a place to stay, I'd recommend the Eagle Cap Chalets, located very close to the lake. There's cabins and condos and chalet rooms available year-round, and also a convenient full-service RV park. And while you're there, don't miss the chance to take the steepest gondola ride in North America. For supplies or current fishing information, stop in at the Sports Corral in the town of Joseph on the way to the lake. And once you're there, remember that at Wallowa, you really can target big fish.
Actually, kind of target the bigger fish, and the way I target the bigger fish is early mornings fish them shallow. I like maggots, I like a lot of sin on my bait, and I really feel that you can target the bigger fish by fishing them shallow early and find them when they're up feeding and they're more vulnerable. Later on, obviously, all you're going to get is into the small fish as the bigger ones go deep. They're pretty wise fish, those big ones. That's kind of what I do is attempt to target the fish. The bigger fish, I probably don't catch as many, but I try and catch quality fish.